I believe I can make a difference. I believe I can make a difference in my town here. I have such an incredible responsibility that I can only give my very best. And there's always room for improvement.
Everything we say presents a positive outlook on teaching because we want the world to see what we really do.
Where do we want these boys and girls to be at the end of the year, and how are we going to get them there?
With all of the parents, I try to make sure that I'm building relationships with both children and with them.
There can be miracles when you believe.
When we have fun, that makes learning exciting, and the children seem to achieve and want to learn more.
Teachers are nice to you every day.
This is where I want my child to be.
We want to do everything we can to make sure that every child in our district has a chance to succeed, and we know that you will. Because every employee here is dedicated to do everything we can that each and every one of you have a chance to succeed and be able to compete in the real world when you leave here.
Well, I'd say never give up.
I'm here in the business office to help teachers, students, and any faculty member that needs my help.
Set goals for yourself and strive hard to achieve those goals. Remember that you can do anything with hard work and dedication.
Respect each other.
I'm the teacher. I have to be positive. I have to give 110% for my students so that they'll give 110% for me.
My children go to Duncanville School and they love it.
There can be miracles.
I'm proud to be a teacher.
We support you daily by making sure that our schools are safe and clean for students and staff.
The food's pretty good. I like going to lunch.
They're cool.
Nosotros somos el servicio de las escuelas. Nosotros estamos aquí todos los días para ustedes, para los estudiantes que tengan un buen año.
From the Superintendent's Office of the Duncanville Independent School District, Dr. Jerry Cook.
Hello, I'm Jerry Cook, Superintendent of Schools of the Duncanville Independent School District. This school year, following the first board meeting of each month, I plan to bring a presentation to the citizens, to the patrons, and to the employees of the Duncanville Independent School District about the events that have taken place over the last month, with particular attention to the actions of the Board of Trustees at the most recent board meeting.
There can be miracles when you believe.
When you believe.
Oh, hope is prayer. It's hard to give. Who knows what miracles you can achieve.
You
win. You.
I'm Charles Haynes, president of the Northwest Educational Foundation. The foundation has been a dream come true for many individuals in the community who have a vision for what education can be in the future.
The Educational Foundation is making a tremendous difference in the lives of our students, teachers, and community. Thanks to the support of our donors, many innovative projects will be implemented in our school district. Our students will continue to benefit from the results of these grants for many years to come.
One of the most successful programs partially funded in recent years by the Northwest Educational Foundation and Intel has been the Northwest Solar Motorsports Program. The Northwest Educational Foundation recently granted $5,000 towards the participation of students in the engineering and constructing of a new solar-powered vehicle. The plans are to race the car in the 2000 Winston Solar Challenge. The current solar car has competed in past Winston Challenges, and Northwest received the Best Sportsmanship Trophy for its attempts. In this program, students gain knowledge, self-esteem, and learn to work as a team. Students learn that life skills that require hard work and perseverance will pay off in the long run. Not many activities affect as many students as profoundly as this challenge will.
I'm Eileen Standridge, Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction, Northwest ISD. It's an extraordinary time to be a teacher. We have before us an amazing group of children. These are the children of technology, and it is our responsibility as adults to teach them how to thrive and how to survive in the new world that awaits them. But to find how to get to that point, to teach those children, is one of our challenges today. That is why it is so imperative that we value and encourage our teachers who are risk takers. We need innovators and creative problem solvers in the classroom. I can't think of a better way to nurture and reward that process than at a very personal level. For a district to be able to say to teachers, here, let us help you. You have a good idea. See what you can do with it. And that's exactly what having grant funding through the foundation allows a district to do. It allows districts to be partners in that creative process. Having that kind of funding available locally will encourage those small, innovative ideas to take shape and to flourish. How many good ideas are never realized because someone thought they were not worthy of major funding? Teachers who might otherwise be intimidated by the daunting task of grant writing will be more likely to pursue local funding for those flashes of creativity. It's absolutely critical that we reach our children. That's what teaching is all about, finding new ways to pass on our knowledge and our history to the future. And these children are our future.
I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. What a wonderful world. Ooh, yeah.
Welcome to the first annual Duncanville ISD Elementary and Secondary Teacher of the Year Awards. Thank you. Texas Teacher of the Year is the highest honor that the state of Texas can bestow upon a teacher. Conducted by the Texas Education Agency, the Texas Teacher of the Year program annually recognizes and rewards teachers who have demonstrated outstanding leadership and excellence in teaching. 40 teachers, two from each regional education service center, compete for two titles, Texas Elementary Teacher of the Year and Texas Secondary Teacher of the Year. The Texas Teacher of the Year winners become spokespersons for public education. They're honored at a special ceremony in Austin, as well as becoming a candidate for the National Teacher of the Year honors. This program is affiliated with the National Teacher of the Year program, the oldest and most prestigious award program to focus on public attention on excellence in teaching. The most important principles in evaluating nominees and their ability to inspire a love of learning in students of all background and abilities include the following: a concern for students and the capability to inspire them, the ability and willingness to work cooperatively with colleagues, a drive in initiating activities that improve instruction for students, an ability to work effectively with different groups in the community, the desire to stay informed about current educational theories and practices, an ability and willingness to make meaningful contributions to education. Examples of innovations started in the nominees' classrooms. And the winner of this year's Duncanville ISD Elementary Teacher of the Year Award goes to Janet Wiggins of Central Elementary School. A longtime favorite within the Duncanville ISD community, Janet Wiggins has enthusiastically embraced the education of all children and is considered to be a consummate professional. Her peers depend on her leadership, and administrative personnel have found her to be an effective teacher who tempers her delivery of information with a deep love for children. Ms. Wiggins has been a spokesperson for Duncanville ISD and for Central Elementary in state and national arenas regarding the LightSpan program and is successful in reaching a broad range of students and parent populations. She has been a pioneer in many instances, being the first volunteer in the district to accept special needs students into her classroom for inclusion education. She continues to meet the needs of all children within her classroom and provides a shining example to all education professionals.
Janet Wiggins is one of the most patient, loving, and tender teachers that I've ever known. She is able to teach to the level of challenge for every student, both the incredibly gifted as well as the autistic, in the same classroom at the same time. She is a very wonderful master teacher.
Congratulations to Janet Wiggins as the Duncanville ISD's Elementary Teacher of the Year. And this year's winner of the Duncanville ISD Secondary Teacher of the Year Award goes to Glenda Sitzler from Reed Middle School. Seeking new inroads to math instruction, Ms. Glenda Sitzler has become a favorite among students, staff, and parents at Reed Middle School. A visit to her classroom will find students integrating technology seamlessly into their classroom discussions and assignments. Small notes from Ms. Sitzler are taped to each student's desk, inspiring them to achieve academic and personal success. Incorporating math songs and cheers have made her middle school classroom an active, fun, and safe environment in which children can excel. Commuting from Bonham, Texas each day provides husband and co-worker Pat Sitzler the opportunity to plan and share with her as an education colleague and a supportive spouse.
We have a lot of time together since we commute quite a great distance. We have quite a bit of time together, so she gets to talk to me quite a bit about what's going on at school and some of the things that she's doing and the way that she does things. It's been a good example for me, and I think her students would agree that she's a person who really cares and who does go above and beyond the call of duty. And she's just a fine person, and I'm just glad that I happen to be married to her and I have her for an example as a teacher.
Her quiet and respectful relationship with students has inspired many to seek her advice about classroom management and academic innovations. She joined the Reed staff in 1981 and continues to set an example for professional educators within the Duncanville ISD family. Join us in congratulating Glenda Sitzler as the Duncanville ISD Secondary Educator of the Year. We would like to congratulate both winners of this year's first annual Duncanville ISD Teacher of the Year Awards.
At graduation, you're thinking about everything that's happened in the past 4 years.
I think I'm really gonna miss my friends.
I'm gonna cry my eyes out on my graduation day. We've been best friends for 4 years.
Best friends since first grade.
It's just yesterday, I feel like, you know, I was a freshman.
If I didn't have my friends, I don't know what I would do.
So we talked all night about the rest of our lives. Where we're gonna be when we turn 25. I keep thinking times will never change. Keep on thinking things will always be the same. But when we leave this year, we won't be coming back. No more hanging out, cause we're on a different track. And if you got something that you need to say, you better say it right now, cause you don't have another day. Cause we're moving on and we can't slow down. These memories are playing like a film without sound. And I keep thinking of that night in June. I didn't know much of love, but it came too soon. And it was me and you, and then we got real blue. Stay at home, talking on the telephone. And we would get so excited and we'd get so scared. Laughing at ourselves, thinking life's not fair. And this is how it feels.
Sometimes I am scared about the future.
I don't know how to say it, but
I am scared about the future.
So if we get the big jobs and we make the big money, when we look back now, will our jokes still be funny? Will we still remember everything we learned in school? Still be trying to break every single rule? Will little Brady Bobby be the stockbroker man? Can he ever find a job that won't interfere with the tan?
Tragically, these same parties, when mixed with alcohol and drug consumption, have resulted in devastation and the end of promising futures.
There he goes. There he goes. Oh. He's fishtailing. Oh, there he goes. He's hit.
To offer seniors of Duncanville High School a safe graduation event to remember, Project Graduation was implemented in 1987 with the encouragement of Sean Christensen, a Duncanville graduate. The idea was initially developed in the state of Maine when tragic fatalities resulted from graduation parties allowing students to drink and drive. The primary goal of Project Graduation activities is to reduce the number of young people involved in drugs and drunk driving accidents. Each year at Duncanville High School, a kickoff luncheon is held to show student leaders what Project Graduation is all about and to encourage student attendance and participation. In addition, local planning, organization, promotion, and fundraising, these are all necessary to successfully implement this idea. Project Graduation is the last opportunity for the senior class to be together as a group for fun activities and fellowship. Project Graduation is sponsored by the Duncanville Independent School District, the Duncanville High School Student Council, the Duncanville Police Department, and the Duncanville Chamber of Commerce.
It's up to you. What's your pleasure?